have a worship service on Thursday night at 7 p.m. called A Service of the Longest Night, an opportunity to acknowledge loss and grief at this time of year. And then, of course, next Sunday is Christmas Eve. We will have worship at 5 p.m., not in the morning, but at 5 p.m., so please join us next Sunday, Christmas Eve at 5 p.m. for our worship service, and any Sunday morning at 10:30, you are welcome here. We welcome those who are joining us via the Be Bloomin' streaming service or through Facebook Live. We hope you enjoy our worship service as well. A few announcements we have this morning. If you, in the pew in front of you, there are blue prayer cards. If you have a specific prayer request, you can write that prayer request on a blue prayer card, and we will pass those to the center during our first hymn, which is O Come, Emmanuel, and our ushers will gather those up and give them to Pastor Greg, and they will be included in our worship service this morning. In the back...
Good morning. My name is Pastor Greg, and I'm the other pastor. But today, I wanted, there's something that we forgot to add in. 10 years ago yesterday, I had the joy of sitting in Little Falls Presbyterian Church in Arlington, Virginia, to witness the ordination of Reverend Heidi Grube at that time. It's Heidi Bolton now. And so today we wanted to honor her ordiversary, as it were. And so we have a gift, at least one, that's from me and the congregation. And there's some other stuff I think Ian has. But before Ian goes, I want to say that it has been a pleasure to watch you carry the mantle of pastor. You are amazing, you are insightful, you are challenging, and you're going to make me cry, so I'll cry. It is a joy to work with you every single day and to watch you continue to wear this mantle well.
Jeremiah 3:15 says, I will give you pastors according to my heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. We are so grateful to you to have you, Heidi, as our pastor, one of our pastors. On this 10th anniversary of your ordination, on behalf of the congregation, I offer you this prayer. Let us pray. Gracious God, with appreciation for Heidi and for her calling to serve us, we pray for her. Grant her guidance for the paths her feet travel, wisdom for the counsel she is asked to give, compassion for those she is called to help, strength to stand for what is true and right even when there is opposition, courage to press on even when things seem so routine, and perseverance to follow the desires you have placed in your heart. Empower this congregation, O God, to support her leadership, appreciate her calling and gifts, and give thanks for the person you have created her to be. Continue to bless her and guide her as we journey through this, through these years and years and years together. And the people said, Amen. Amen.
Amazing. make sure that you know those too. Some of the music you will be singing is in the bulletin. Just to make sure it's clear, for the song, it's on page 5 of To a Maid Engaged to Joseph. Betsy will be singing the verse 1 and 2, and you need to join in on verses 3 and 4. That is there in the bulletin. And then on Silent Night, as you see, the introduction is sung by some of our cast, and we, this is new, so this is the part to pay attention to. Verses 1 and 2, we all are going to sing together, and verses 3 and 4, we all are going to hum together. So you get a chance to hum today. How often is that? That would be fun. So hum verses 3 and 4 of Silent Night. All of the children are going to do an amazing job, and you are going to want to clap all the time because they're so cute and adorable, but we ask that we hold our applause until the end so that they can get through what they've practiced and we can show our appreciation at the end. One last announcement I forgot is that we have new hymnals in our pews, as you'll see, that are purple Glory to God, which means we have a whole bunch of hymnals that we use for many years. They are on a table in the back. If you would like one for home use or to share with someone, you are welcome to take one of those at the end of the service. That is all of the announcements that I have, and then some, obviously, that I did not know were happening. Are there other announcements from the congregation? I'm almost afraid to ask. Anne, yes.
You all aren't exhausted from today's ruckus when you're done. There is a skate with Santa at the ice rink in town at 1:45 today. It runs for an hour and a half, and Santa will be there to greet your little ones if you'd like to go. It's a good, healthy family activity. More information on the kiosk up there.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. If there are no other announcements, let us prepare our hearts and minds to worship by joining together in the song, Call to Worship.
Thank you. from Isaiah. Then he said, "Hear now, O house of David. It is a small thing for you to weary men, but will you weary my God also? Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel." A reading from Micah. "But you, Bethlehem Ephratah, though you are little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of you shall come forth to me the one to be the ruler in Israel, whose goings forth are from of old, from everlasting." And a reading from Isaiah. "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. Upon the throne of David and over his kingdom, to order it and establish it with judgment and justice from that time forward, even forever."
There isn't. Thank you. Miss Watkins?
Yes?
I'm Fred Worcester from the Building and Grounds.
Yes, Mr. Worcester?
The committee wanted me to make sure that you had addressed the halo problem.
The halo?
The glitter! The glitter, Miss Watkins. We can't have glitter in the church.
I assure you, Mr. Worcester, the halos have been deglittered.
Very well. Thank you.
Thank you. will play. This will be a piece of cake.
Who are you, the Christmas pageant cheerleader?
Nope, angel of the Lord with the good news.
Okay, everyone, let's get back to it. Let's see what's next.
What's this? What's this? No, 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 this is far too plain. I see a bold time in your backdrop and flashing lights and a trapeze for the angels. And with glitter.
I'm sorry for you.
I'm Frost Clipper from the best from Corbett.
Corporate?
I'm here. Now, we are going
Really cute and alive.
just think it's going to be a disaster.
Be of good courage. But God loves interpretive dance and dogs and lions and kids who are so nervous they might throw up and kids who want to fight the bad guys and glitter on people.
God also loves halos without glitter. The beauty of God's
please join me in the prayer of dedication printed in your bulletin. Lord, hear our prayer.
God, we commit ourselves to breathing deeply of all the life that you give, so that we may be equipped to heal the burdens of our world with the healing power of your Spirit, until we are one as you are one, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
As is our tradition here at First Presbyterian Church in Red Wing, we have little blue prayer cards with petitions. I would ask for a petition of my own. On Tuesday, my father, John, will have his second knee replacement surgery. So prayers for his successful surgery and his recovery. Because they're coming to babysit for us in April. So Lynn Dulock asked for prayers for her father, who suffers from Alzheimer's, and for her mother, who is his full-time caregiver. Special prayers for Dick and Nancy Bennett as Dick endures the progression of his cancer. He is now in need of using a wheelchair and a hospital bed. And that prayer comes from Daisy Hofer. Ty Rogers asks for prayers of strength for all who use their voice under tough circumstances. Debbie asks for prayers for Mary Kay as she enters hospice this Christmas, that she find peace and comfort in the support of her friends. Debbie also asks for prayers for Bill Chalmers and his continued healing and renewed strength following his surgery. And Ron and Jane Ward offer prayers of celebration for 56 years of being together. Let us pray. Open our eyes, Lord, especially if they are half shut because we are tired of looking, or half open because we fear to see too much, or blurred with tears because yesterday and today and tomorrow are filled with the same pain, or contracted because we only look at what we want to see. Open our eyes, Lord, to gently scan the life we lead, the home we have, the world we inhabit, and so to find among the gremlins and grayness signs of hope we can fasten on and encourage. Give us, whose eyes are dimmed by familiarity, a bigger vision of what you can do, even with hopeless cases and lost causes and people of limited abilities. Show us the world as in your sight, riddled by debt, deceit, and disbelief, yet also shot through with possibility for recovery, renewal, redemption. And lest we fail to distinguish vision from fantasy, today, tomorrow, this week, open our eyes to one person or one place where we, being even for a moment prophetic, might identify and mean a potential in the waiting. And with all of this, open our eyes in yearning for Jesus. On the mountains, in the cities, through the corridors of power and streets of despair, to help, to heal, to comfort, to convert, O come, Emmanuel. And let us join with the choirs of angels and saints from every time and place in the prayer that our Savior Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you.
Ariana and Betsy and Kingsley and Luana and Kylie and Amara and Justin and David and Jessica and Hannah and Ginger and Jack and Jennifer Beck for all of their work and time today in putting this on. And I want to thank Tom for playing and Joanne for playing and all those that made this possible. I want to remind you that fellowship is downstairs, so you go and greet the cast down there. Also, the most important thing here at our congregation is for you to know what they told you, that you are beloved. Every single day, God looks down upon you and says, "Beloved, with you I am well pleased." Whether you're a lion, or an innkeeper, or a pastor, or someone from buildings and grounds, you are loved unconditionally, and there's nothing you can do about it. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all now and forever. Amen.